All right, guys, I just got this from CoinKite. Package slip. All right, we have 1x cold card. And what we're gonna do is check the number here that corresponds to the number that would be on this in the enclosed package. And we also got ourselves a cold card queue, which hopefully is inside there. And I'll be unboxing this as well. All right, so we just received this ColdCard Mk4, and what's very important is to make sure that the number up here corresponds to the number here, which will correspond to the number inside and on the actual device. So we're going to verify this first of all, and we're going to open it up and see what's inside. All right, so inside we've got a bunch of things. We've got the ColdCard itself. Couple of stickers, a piece of paper for our seed phrase and pin. And so it's just very important, the barcode slip that was packed inside the tamper-proof package corresponds to the number that was on the outside. As we can see, those two are exactly the same. And then when we power this baby up, and I'm going to be using my USB power bar to power it up. When we open it up and go into settings, we will see the exact same number, should see the exact same number as what's indicated over here. So let's plug this in. All right, so there's going to be a few instructions as we power it up. Get my glasses so I can see what the fuck's going on here. All right, so by using this product, you are accepting the terms and sales of use. Just going to scroll down. Hope you can see this and it's sharp. So read the full document at, and it gives you the website, coldcardwallet.com, legal. Press OK to accept terms and conditions to continue. So we will say OK, and that is the check mark in the bottom there. So click OK. And now it displays the barcode number at the top. So I'm just going to make sure that those are exactly the same. And they do look to be exactly the same. So we can verify that this is legitimately from CoinKite and it has not been tampered with. All right. So we're just going to keep scrolling through. Your new cold card should have arrived, sealed in a bag with the above number, which we've just checked. And take a moment to look for any signs of tampering, okay, which we have done. Take a picture and correct and contact CoinKite, support at CoinKite if there are any concerns, okay? So anything that doesn't add up here, and if this doesn't correspond with the number on the cold card, then contact support. So we are gonna say, I think we're gonna keep scrolling down. We can just say, okay. All right, so now we're gonna choose the PIN code. And we will write the PIN on the backup card that they provide for now. And then once we have everything written down and the words, we're going to stamp those into metal. But just for now, we're going to use this and we'll get set up. So to choose the PIN, you're going to say check the check mark at the bottom right. It says choose a PIN. And it gives you an example of a, okay, so the PIN on the cold card, there is broken into two parts. You're going to have a prefix and a suffix, okay? So after you enter the first part of the PIN, you will get two anti-phishing words, and then you'll enter the second part of the PIN. And this is just to verify that it is actually the correct PIN and nothing has been tampered with. So if you ever enter your PIN and you're not seeing the two anti-phishing words, you know that either you've entered the PIN incorrectly in the beginning, or that there's some tampering has gone on and your device may be corrupt. So first of all, let's get the PIN set up and then we'll go forward. So again, absolutely, there's a warning again. Absolutely, there's no way to reset the PIN. So make sure you do write it down. Do not forget the PIN code. Okay, oh my God, okay. So you actually have to hit 6 to say, yes, you've read this and you approve. So we're gonna hit 6. Okay, so now we're going to enter the prefix of our PIN. So I'm going to do that right now off camera. So I enter the prefix of the PIN, and I get my two anti-phishing words, which I will make note of as well and make sure to write them down. Okay, and then once you've written those two words down, we're gonna scroll, we're gonna say enter, say yes, the suffix of your PIN, and hit enter again, and then your PIN will be set. So I'm gonna do that off camera, and go. And that'll load up. And then from there, we'll be able to set up our seed words. All right, guys, so just a little thing. When you do get your cold card, check the firmware, because I had a problem with mine. It kept crashing. That's why I actually changed my battery. I thought it was my battery, but it was actually the firmware. So I noticed that when it shipped, it had a firmware of 5.20. And when I checked on the website, it actually, the latest version is a 5.4. So you want to make sure that you are on the latest firmware. And to do that, you just scroll down to Advanced Tools, go into Advanced Tools, and then go to Firmware, Upgrade Firmware, and then it will say Show Version, and I have now updated it. So I'm now on 5.4, but it did ship with a 5.2, and it was crashing on me. So there is a link. I have another tutorial on how to verify and download the latest firmware for ColdCard. So I'll leave that in the show notes below. But just the thing, if your cold card is crashing on you, check the, first of all, check the battery source, and then also check the firmware is up to date. So continuing now, guys, with the seed phrase, we're going to write our seed phrase on the card provided, making sure that they're in the correct numerical order. And I'm going to do a 12-word seed phrase. You can choose the 24 or the dice roll. But for simplicity, I'm going to use a 12 word, which is just as secure as a 24. I mean, there's a marginal difference between the two, but 12 words is what we're doing today. So make sure you write them down on the card provided and in the correct order, spelt correctly. And then obviously keep this very safe and out of sight from anybody, because you do not want to share these words. These words are essentially your key. Okay, so this is all you'll need to recover your wallet if ever you were to lose your wallet. So the seed phrase is very important. Keep it written down in the correct order and spelled correctly, and we'll catch you on the other side. So we have our seed set up. We have double checked. We've gone through the whole process. Now our card is ready. And now what we want to do is we want to configure this cold card to use with Sparrow. And to do that, we're going to need our micro SD card. And I'm just going to say gold teeth facing you, slide that in. And hope this is centered. Okay, so now what we want to do is we are going to scroll down to Advanced Tools. We're going to go into Advanced Tools, and we're going to say Export Wallet. Export, and we want to choose Sparrow Wallet and say yes. Okay, and this is the JSON file which we're going to save to the micro SD card. Press 1 to enter a non-zero. So I just keep this as 0. I don't push 1. It's a little bit more technical. So just scroll through and then just say okay. And that will generate the JSON file, which we will take from the micro SD card and transfer it to our computer, which is running Sparrow. If you want to see a Sparrow download, there's tutorials in the link show notes below. So be sure to check that out before you try to do this tutorial. All right, guys, so we are in Sparrow and the SD card is plugged into my computer, and we are going to say create a new wallet. And we're going to give it a name. We're going to call it ColdCard Mk4 Create Wallet. Okay, so it'll be a single signature. And what we want to do is with the ColdCard, we are going to use the air gapped version. So we're going to select the air gapped option.
and we are going to select the cold card option from the top and say import file. So I'm going to click import file, and I'm going to go to my my SD card, and I'm going to select the .json file, and I'm going to say open. And that right away, that loads the cold card into Sparrow. So yeah, it's a single sig, it's a native SegWit. Just keep this as is. And then this information here, you don't need to change anything here, and just say apply. You can give your wallet a password. Personally, I don't give it a password. For a more in-depth tutorial on Sparrow, I do have other tutorials on Sparrow, which goes into the details of it. I will link those again in the show notes below. But for now, this will give you just a quick breakdown of the transactions. I've done a few transactions now, but you got your transactions, you got your send tab, and your receive tab, which will have all your addresses. And for this tutorial, what I'll do is I'll send a few sats in, and then we'll send some sats out, and you'll see how you have to use the cold card to sign the transaction for sending sats out. So you can receive Bitcoin no problem. Okay, you just have to give the Bitcoin address, which you'll find in the receive tab. And then when you send Bitcoin, you will need to sign it with your cold card, and we'll demonstrate that too. So for now, I'm just going to send some sats in, and then once those come in, we'll do the sending out and signing with the cold card. All right, so guys, we have one confirmation. You can see there's one little pie that's filled in. So we can now actually send this back out. So what I'll do is I'll send this out to my Bitcoin wallet. So I'm just going to go to send, and I've pasted in my Bitcoin address at the top here. I'm just going to give it a label. It's actually going to my Blink. And now we want to just check the mempool, because this is where the fees come in. And the fees are up a little bit. So it's at 9 sats VB for the low priority. So that's 9 sats per virtual byte. That's up a little bit from yesterday. Yesterday was very low. So a lot of activity today. But we're going to send this out, and I'll show you how you sign. So the fee, I'm just going to leave it as is right there. Keep it fairly low priority. But I'm going to send back the amount that I just sent in. So to do that, I go to the UTXO tab, and I'm going to select the UTXO that is just coming in, which is this one here. Okay. So it's literally about $50. So I'm going to select that, and I'm just going to say send selected, and that's going to my Bitcoin address. I've given it the label. I'm going to leave the fees as they are, and then I'm going to say create transaction. Okay, so now I need to finalize transaction for signing. So I'm going to say finalize transaction for signing, and I'm going to save it to my SD card, which will take and put it back into the cold card to sign. So I'm going to use this option here, save transaction, and it's going to be called the Blink PSBT, and I'm saving it to my micro SD and click save. All right, so guys, now that the partly signed transaction has been saved to the SD card, we're going to put the SD card into the cold card. I'm just going to slot it in there, gold teeth towards us. Hopefully you can see that. And it says ready to sign. So we're going to say yes. And I say validating. Okay to send that amount of Bitcoin. It's going to tell us the network fee. Is that one input, one output, and it's sending to that address, which looks good. So you can just verify that. Scroll down to the bottom, and we're going to say okay to sign. So I'm going to say okay to sign that transaction. Signing, saving. Okay, so now it's signed. So now we're going to take it from the SD card out of the cold card back into the computer
and then broadcast it to the network. So I'm just going to take this out. I'm going to put it back in the card reader over here. And we'll catch you in the desktop again.
Back in the desktop in Sparrow, what we want to do now is load the transaction. So we're going to say load transaction. And we're going to load that from our micro SD card. And it is the signed PSBT, so the partly signed Bitcoin transaction. That's the file we want. And we're going to say open. Okay, so it validates the signature, and all we got to do now is hit broadcast transaction. And we broadcast that, and that has gone to the wallet that we designated. All right, guys, so that is how we use the ColdCard Mk4 or MK4 to sign transactions using the air gap method of the SD card. ColdCard make really good products. I really recommend the Mk4 or the ColdCard Q. So lots more coming, guys. Give us a like and subscribe if you learned something, and we'll catch you in the next one.